Hello!
Welcome.
Joined today by my brother, Andrew.
How are we doing?
He's brought his beers for us to try. Oh, me and you.
this one, I was in a Kirkstall homebrew shop.
Cool.
And they had a set of these, and it is Design Your Mini Mash, which is part kit, part... oatmeal and that, and inside, you've got all the instructions in there. Man.
So is it part brew kit, part all grain?
Yeah,
it's, all right, cool.
It's like 50-50 of it. And,
I think one of the umbrellas we've tried before, Martin's one from friends down south, they've done that.
And what is it? It says it's an oatmeal style. And, like I say, what says on back?
Is it brown head and slight cocoa?
And with this one, you had two cans of wort, but I also had to steep the grain.
What is steeping? We've done this before, it's just so like
sitting the grain.
Is it a mesh bag or something sort of?
Yeah, it's just like sitting it in a sparge bag, and you just it's like a tea bag method, you know what I mean? You just stick it in the water. So it gets some of the flavour of oats.
Sorry, that's the wrong joke in my head. Teabagging. So do you always do teabagging, Andrew?
But yeah, I mean, it's like the same method as a teabag. Steeping it, you know what I mean? You know, letting get some of the flavours off the grain, oats and stuff like that. And
so it's almost like an hybrid kit. So yeah, on the aromas. Coffee cream. Yeah, coffee cream. You get a little bit of almost like charcoal like smell on it.
Yeah, I mean, that might be the oats, because Ed.
Did they actually have proper oats, like porridge oats?
Along with some other damp grains.
So you get that actual ingredients. Is it a slight change from when you did kits?
Yeah, because not only that, using these grains as well. It was also when you take that out.
Cheers.
I had to boil it with the hops and stuff. That lost another process as well.
You find exciting that you learn all these new techniques.
Well, that's it. It's the more I'm getting into it, the more it's getting in thriving. It's more.
And does it remind you of when you was learning to be a chef and stuff like that? All those new
it's methods. Like you said, it's learning new methods, new techniques, and
expanding yourself.
Yeah, that's it. Personal. I mean, like the latest ones now I've been brewing. It's like
Buddy is the medium. Slight almost dryness on the back end, a little bit of like powdered chocolate.
I mean, I almost got a bit of a black treacle at one point.
Black treacle's a little bit denser, it's a little more heavier. But ABV on this is 5%. Definitely quaffable.
Yeah.
Because of the balance in the palate, it's really easy to drink. But yeah. Well done, Andrew. So this is your first hybrid kit. $29.99. As you can expect, of course, using actual ingredients.
Yeah.
As in, when you're a chef, the expense goes a little bit up.
Plus, with the difference to the other kit, it's not.
Yeah.
It's not just. I think there's two different types of kits in it.
The original brew kits, it's just syrups and.
Yeah. Just add water and just yeast.
And that's why they're about £10 or £15. Whereas this has got actual ingredients. I mean, much like when you buy your chef, paying for actual ingredients is...
Well, that's it. There's more technique to this one as well. Bigger process than just fermenting it. There's more techniques to it.
Yeah, cool. But yes, very nice cooking beer. Thanks, Andrew, for bringing this today. Would you try another hybrid kit again, or...?
Well, I've recently just evolved from that now.
And, oh, wow, cool!
I I'd say I'm evolving each time.
Yeah, learning from your mistakes.
Yeah.
I mean, initially, I think you're rushing it. I mean, no, when you rush stuff, it ends up being...
Yeah. I mean, like, I rushed one kit, and it turned out bad, so...
But you did, if I remember rightly, you told me, you did this in two brews in one day. The first one was your last ever kit.
Yeah.
And your second one in that day was this. They've both been good. So,
must have had a good day.
So, you learn quickly and adapted, and that's cool.
Well, that's it. The idea with chefing, you've got to learn and adapt really quickly.
And you use your speed in the right way.
And what I've noticed for this is that it's like, if all goes on, you've got to be able to, adapt to it and so that you don't ruin your beer.
But would you recommend other people try this, or would you recommend kit first and then?
It's a good stepping stone. But I'd say it's not bad to.
Do you prefer to brew dark beers to light beers?
Well, it's...
Or is it just a personal choice?
It was...
Do what you like first.
Because it was the time of the year, you know what I mean? In winter time.
Cool.
You all love dark beers. And now I'm just I'm doing some IPAs now, and so coming up to summertime. So I've got an English IPA and an American IPA, which I do to brew, you know what I mean? So
that's good.
And just a traditional bitter.
Are you going to actually get around to working on your own recipes eventually?
Well, that's it. It's like...
Because we know you like to experiment with food.
Well, that's it. Once I've done these IPAs, by then I should have a good technique of...
On your skills as you did
and then, chef. And then the first one that I'll probably do my own recipe is a honey brown ale. So I've got some fermented honey.
Nice.
From my local beehive as well.
Spot local.
Yeah.
You take care.
Goodbye.